If you're a huge fan of Parks and Rec like I am, you'll know that it's important to treat yourself. My name is Dr. Jason Hooper, Doctor of Physical Therapy and Orthopedic Clinical Specialist, and today we're going to talk about instrument-assisted soft tissue mobilization. We're going to talk about what it is, why we do it, and how you can create a program for yourself at home. So at the cellular level, what this is doing is causing acute inflammation, which is basically going to restart that healing cycle. It's going to help to reabsorb fibrosis, or kind of break down and reabsorb scar tissue, while also promoting cellular activity to help with our healing and remodeling, which will make the healing process faster and allow our tissue to heal stronger and better. So it's also been shown to be really beneficial to increase range of motion, which is why we'll talk about in our program that we should stretch after we do this technique, and if done appropriately, it can help decrease pain in athletes. So to better do this at home, we're going to talk about the program of what we're going to do. So whatever area you're going to be working on, you need to warm up. If it's your hands, you need to do some like tendon gliding or just anything to get the blood pumping. If you're trying to do it to your legs or anything else that's been an injured tissue, same thing. You just got to warm that tissue up. Maybe that's doing like some jump rope if you're tolerable to that, or doing just some active range of motion. If it's your hands, just doing some elbow wrist flexion or doing some tendon glides to get the hands warmed up. Now for our technique, there's four important factors we're gonna talk about: angle, time, direction of force, and the style. The style we'll spend the most time talking about. The angle is gonna be at about 45 degrees. Now the research, they do it anywhere from 30 to 60 degrees, so obviously 45 lands perfectly in the middle of that, but that's what you're gonna be looking at, okay? You're not coming straight up and down on it, you're coming in at about 45 degree angle. Time-wise, research has done it anywhere from about 1 to 2 minutes, but it's okay. I actually usually say 3 to 5 minutes per body part, but if you don't have that much time, 1 to 2 minutes per section is gonna be okay. Now, a common question with this is gonna be direction. Like, do I have to go like parallel to the fibers? Can I go across the fibers? The answer is yes, you can do both. The research supports doing both like parallel along with the fibers that you're working on and across. Just be careful, you know, modulating the pressure that you use to your comfort level, whether you're going parallel or across. And also make sure that you're not like running across like a lot of joints that may cause discomfort. You don't want to do this on bony structures. So be careful if you're changing your direction that you're all of a sudden not rubbing over a bony structure. Now it's important to pay attention to the pressure with this. So the pressure needs to be moderate to heavy pressure. That's what the research supports has the best influence on the cellular remodeling. So if you're going faster, you should probably do moderate pressure. Or if you're going a little bit slower, that's when you can tolerate the deep pressure better. Now with the style of this, there's gonna be three that we wanna talk about. So with the cross-fixation, that's gonna be like kind of moderate pressure and faster strokes. With the deep tissue or the deep fascial release, that's gonna be deeper pressure, but you may not be going as fast. It's okay to speed up with that, but you may not be going as fast as you would the cross fixation. The last style we're gonna talk about is stripping. So this is a more aggressive style, so you need to be careful if you're new to this. This goes by different names. If you're Tom Brady and his trainer, they call it pliability, I believe, and that's what's, you know, allowing him to still play right now, or so they say. But this is an aggressive technique that will really promote that cellular structure changes. You just have to be careful with what you're doing. So this is actually working up against the muscle as you go while extending that tissue. So lengthening the tissue as you create that pressure up against it. My recommendation is to start with lighter pressure to see if you can tolerate it and then build as it becomes more comfortable. You wanna kinda go fast with this and eventually it's fast and hard. You're gonna get a lot of reddening in the tissue from doing this. That's perfectly normal as long as you're not causing yourself a ton of pain or you're noticing like any bruising. All right, so you've done your anywhere from like 2 to 5 minutes of techniques on the different spots. Now what do you do afterwards? So if you're using this more as a like kind of remodeling and healing from an injury method, then what you're gonna wanna do is just stretch that tissue out afterwards. So if you did it to your palm, stretch the palm out. If you did it to your wrist extensors, stretch the wrist extensors out afterwards. Do we strength train after this? it's actually a good time to work on your strength after this if you're in kind of the later stages of your healing. So if you had this chronic issue that, you know, you can climb on, but you're trying to heal it and you're using this technique to kind of hasten that healing process, you want to do the instrument assisted, you want to stretch the tissue out a little bit, and then you go through your exercises for that tissue. If you strengthen or not afterwards kind of depends on your goals. So for me personally at home, I will do this technique prophylactically. Like, I do it just to keep everything nice and healthy. So I may not have time to do the strengthening afterwards. That's okay. I still warm the tissue up, perform my techniques, and then stretch out afterwards. So that for me is prophylactic. I'm not trying to heal from an injury, so I don't need to do the strengthening afterwards. Do what works best for you and what you have time for. So how often can you use this technique? Honestly, if you're not getting any negative effects from it, you're not getting any bruising, you're not really sore afterwards, it can be done daily. Or if you're like trying to get ready for that climbing trip that's in 2 weeks, you can do it a couple of times a day. It's not going to hurt the tissue, but if you do feel sore, let it rest and recover, so that way you're not just kind of continually scrape down on that injured tissue. Remember, this is restarting that healing process, so you need to let that process continue and go through that full cycle before you go aggressive on it again. So how do we know if this is actually working for you? Well, the more obvious signs are going to be decreased pain, increased range of motion, or maybe feeling stronger with those exercises you're working on. The less obvious is obviously the healing timeline. The research does support this as an effective technique. So if you're not getting those negative signs, you're getting positive signs like decreased pain, improved circulation, range of motion, then this technique is working for you and you're probably doing it correctly. Okay, so are there any times when you really shouldn't do this? So, I mean, obviously, like, you shouldn't do it over like any sutures or any open wounds or those very like acute recent injuries, like you just heard it yesterday. You know, maybe trying to restart that healing process isn't what you should be doing because it just started. But for a full list of like these reasons why you should or maybe should not do it, check out the show notes because there's a lot more things in there to explain when you should and shouldn't do it. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. And until next time, train, climb, send, repeat. And don't forget, treat yourself. You know that it's important to treat yourself.
Bro, Parks and Rec isn't even on TV anymore. Nobody's gonna get that reference.
I don't care, okay? I love it. It's still relevant. I watched it this morning. And then if you can just show, a snippet of Ron Swanson, that'd be great, because he's my favorite.
Another, please.
Okay. Are we good? All right. I just forgot what all the things are I'm supposed to say.
Yeah, but who are you again?
No. Parks and Rec. That was my intro. This is the hard part that I mentioned, the cellular part. Okay. While causing, God, this is the hard part. So at the cellular level, cellular level. So at the cellular, gosh, why am I, the more I say that word, I had it till the end. Bam.
Got it.
No more.
Nailed it.
Football, soccer, volleyball, and climbing. No, I don't like that one. Okay, what is it? Why we do it? Okay, decrease pain, yeah. Fast speed, moderate pressure, deep speed, deep pressure. Generally feeling a little bit stronger after you do this exercise. Yeah, but I'm fancy. So how about if I say, so like for a full list of like contraindications or reasons, come on, Tweet yourself Tuesday every week. Please like and subscribe, and don't forget, dang it. Please hit that like and subscribe button. All right, we're good. We're good, we're good.
Oh, hey, you're still here. Jason, they're still watching.
Oh, heyo.
Dude, say something cool so they like the videos and subscribe for more awesome content.
Like and subscribe for more super sweet vids, y'all.
So lame, dude. So lame.
I thought it was pretty good.